G'day, ZiggyD here, and in this guide I want to go over each of the three guard skills and which one you should use in different builds. The guard skill category includes the reworked Molten Shell, the reworked Immortal Call, and the new Steelskin skill. Each of these are incredibly powerful defensive tools that you should definitely be taking advantage of, and there is a skill and usage style that will fit every build. Guard skills all share cooldowns, so you can and only should be using one of these in your build. The first I want to go over is Immortal Call. This skill now gives a short duration that mitigates both physical and elemental damage, minus 25% taken at low levels and about 35% at level 20. Immortal Call only has a 1 second base duration, but both the physical mitigation and the duration goes up substantially if you have available endurance charges for it to consume. It can consume up to 5 endurance charges, gaining 20% duration and 15% physical mitigation per charge consumed. This means that a level 1 Immortal Call with 5 endurance charges will mitigate 100% of physical damage for 2 seconds, assuming you have no other duration increases. The elemental damage mitigation stays at the baseline the gem provides depending on the level. It's worth noting that Immortal Call does mitigate damage over time effects. Steelskin lasts 1.5 seconds and mitigates 70% of damage taken from hits. However, it has a maximum amount of damage it can take before the buff is destroyed, starting at a tiny 54 and going up to 2209 at level 20. You can think of this like a secondary health pool, similar to how Mind of a Matter works. 70% of the damage taken from the hit goes to Steelskin's life, and 30% goes to your life or energy shield. Steelskin protects against any hit-based damage, including elemental, physical, and chaos, but it won't protect from damage over time effects. Molten Shell lasts 3 seconds and provides some armor, 50 at level 1, going to 858 at level 20. It then gives you a damage shield similar to Steelskin that is based on 20% of your armor you had when the buff was created. So if you have 10,000 armor, it will give you a Molten Shell that can absorb 2,000 damage. Molten Shell absorbs 75% of incoming hit damage, with the damage absorbed going to the health pool of the Molten Shell and the other 25% going to you. Molten Shell also explodes, dealing between 100 and 3,000% of the damage taken to it when it expires or has its health pool depleted. Some builds might do things with this damage reflect, but it's not super important to our discussion of defensive application. Like Steelskin, Molten Shell protects against any hit-based damage, including elemental, physical, and chaos, but it won't protect you from damage over time effects. So, that's how they work, but what should you use in your build and why? Steelskin is the skill of choice for builds that don't have armor or a steady supply of endurance charges. It absorbs 70% and boosts your effective health pool by 2200 at level 20. Its base duration is somewhat short at 1.5 seconds, and I recommend linking it to increased duration support gem to make it much easier to use. The downside of Steelskin is that it must be manually cast or used on a very high level cast when damage taken setup. This is because the amount of damage it can absorb is quite low at lower levels of the gem, so Steelskin is rather limited in scope to high level cast when damage taken or manual use. But it is powerful and doesn't require any further investment on your character to work outside of the strength requirements of the gem. I mainly recommend Steelskin for spellcasters that have enough strength or bow builds that don't have a steady supply of endurance charges. Do not put a low-level Steelskin on cast when damage taken, as it will do effectively nothing. Mainly, I recommend using it manually. It only has a 3-second cooldown, and the quality on the gem lowers the cooldown further, so use it liberally. In summary, spellcasters and builds without armor or endurance charges should use a high-level Steelskin if they can. Immortal Call is a bit more flexible on the other hand. A low-level Immortal Call mitigates around a quarter of incoming damage without any further investment. So this is a skill that you can automate on a low-level cast when damage taken setup and still receive a solid benefit from. If you have a steady supply of endurance charges, say from Warlord's Mark, it will last longer and mitigate more physical damage. Without endurance charges, the duration is very short at only 1 second, so this favors automation in those builds. If you have a good amount of endurance charges, you can automate, however, it will eat your charges, so this is only recommended if you're constantly generating them. If you want more control over when your charges are consumed, a high level cast when damage taken will mitigate more elemental damage and will consume your endurance charges for large or full physical immunity for 2 seconds or more. So, in summary, Immortal Call works well for automation at both high and low levels, and will work for automation in builds that constantly generate endurance charges. Builds that have endurance charges but don't generate them very quickly may prefer to manually cast a high-level Immortal Call. It's a catch-all skill that will work well in all builds, but on spellcasters or other builds without endurance charges, it will not mitigate as much as a high-level Steelskin, unless you are taking very large amounts of damage that would deplete Steelskin's health pool. Anyone can use it to decent effect, though. Molten Shell is extremely strong, but much more niche. It mitigates more than Steelskin and can have a larger absorption amount. However, it has a longer cooldown than Steelskin and requires armor investment to be effective. At 11,000 armor, Molten Shell gives the same absorb shield as Steelskin. However, you want to go a bit above that to make the higher cooldown worthwhile. As such, I'd recommend that builds with at least 15,000 armor use Molten Shell. That's including the Granite Flask effect and Molten Shell's armor that it provides. Manually casting Molten Shell at high level is fantastic as it allows you to gain a large amount of armor and absorb shield when you need it. Automation is also decent, and a mid to high level Molten Shell on cast when damage taken will work well with high armor builds. Overall, if you have 15k or more armor, use Molten Shell however you like. So just to go over it again and truly oversimplify it, casters and low armor builds use a high level Steelskin manually if you have the strength requirement. High armor builds, that is 15,000 or more, use Molten Shell manually or cast when damage taken. And for everyone else, use Immortal Call on a low level cast when damage taken or manually if you have endurance charges to spare. Automation is fine if you have a constant flow of endurance charges like with Warlord's Mark. So throw on your best fitting guard skill and enjoy the solid survivability boost. It's especially important in some of those nasty and legion encounters of this expansion. That's it for now, I'm ZiggyD, and thanks for watching.